viewers, hope you are doing well. Welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I am your tutor, Sarah Wamaitha. So today we are going to look at the topic, Creation and the Fall of Humankind, in the subtopic, Traditional African Concept of Evil. Welcome. We start by our lesson goals or the objectives. I expect by the end of the lesson, the learner to be able to explain the concept of evil as told by the traditional African religion. What is evil? In the traditional African society, evil was an offense against God, spirits, and ancestors. It was also viewed as an offense against another person or community. Evil was also a misfortune that can befall an individual or a community. So that's what is evil in traditional African society. Then we look at the causes of evil. And we see that many of the traditional African societies do not associate God with evil. They say that God is not the creator of evil. Some communities, however, believe that evil is an external power that exists on its own. Thus, in the traditional African society, evil was understood or it's explained as something mysterious that was caused by several people and things. Let's see some of the causes of evil in traditional African society. One is the evil feeling, evil spirits. They believe that evil spirits causes evil in traditional African society. Another thing is the ancestral spirits. They believe that due to disobedience to them, the ancestral spirits causes evil. Another cause of evil is that some animals like the chameleon are sources of evil. Those are like some communities like the Akamba, they believe that chameleons brought evil. Other communities believe that if an owl cries near one's homestead, it's a sign of evil. So we see some communities believe that some animals are sources of evil. Another cause of evil is that people with mystical powers, for example, the magic, sorcery, and witchcraft are evil. They believe people with mystical powers, example, magic, sorcery, and witchcraft are evil. We see that even today, like, people go to certain or visit the sorcerers because they believe that they have mystical powers, which are source of evil. Another cause of evil is that if a member of community breaks a taboo, breaking of a taboo is believed to be a cause of evil. That was disobedience. And this action may bring evil spirits. Breaking of taboos in some communities, they believe it's disobedience and the action may bring evil spirits. They also believe that the spirit of death causes evil. Some communities believe the spirit of death causes evil. If they are not remembered or respected, maybe during ceremonies, if they are not remembered or they are not respected, given the respect they deserve, they can cause evil, these spirits of death. They can cause harm and also violence. So those are the causes of evil in traditional African communities. Let's see the consequences of evil in traditional African society. What were the consequences of this evil in traditional African society? One is barrenness. You'll find that a woman will not be able to give birth. Consequence of evil is barrenness. Another consequence is drought. Drought. Another community, there may be drought for a long period. That's a consequence of evil. Epidemics are also consequences of evil. Madness is also a consequence of evil. People get mad in the community and we believe that it's a consequence of evil. Sickness. Someone can get a certain disease that is incurable. and it's believed it's a consequence of evil. Physically and mentally handicapped children. Women can be giving birth to physically and mentally handicapped children, and they can believe it's a consequence of evil. Death. People die as a result of evil in the society. Drowning. Burning in a house. They believe it's also a consequence of evil in traditional Ghana society. War. And rebellious children. Give birth to rebellious children can be said to be a consequence of evil in traditional African society. So we have looked at what is evil. We have seen the traditional African belief about evil, and we have seen the causes of evil in traditional African society, and we have also seen the consequences of evil in traditional African society. So that's the end of the lesson, and we have an activity. You answer the following question. Activity 1, explain the concept of evil in the traditional African communities. And the second one, state 6, consequences of evil in traditional African society. For our references, you can refer to Secondary Christian Religious Education Student Book 1, KLB 3rd edition. Thank you for joining us. For this and more, you can contact us through our SMS number, which is on the screen. You can also find us on YouTube, Elimu TV, on Facebook, Elimu TV, and on Twitter at Elimu TV_KE. See you next time.